Hey guys, welcome to E-Man's Movie Reviews. I'm E-Man, and my handwriting is terrible. I barely passed any test that I took in high school, because I could barely read the notes that I took in my notebook. That, and I also did a lot of drawing and doodling, so I wasn't exactly paying attention, but still, my handwriting is complete garbage. My signature is just a straight line, which annoys people because it looks like I refuse to sign important documents or checks. But no, that's just my signature. This week, I'm going to be reviewing the movie Gone Girl, which was made in 2014 by Mr. David Fincher. Now, every time that I see Ben Affleck starring in a movie, I am pretty hesitant to watch it, because he really just hams it up, and I can never really get into the movie or the story because of his poor performance. It boggles my mind that he keeps getting roles, when there are so many other actors who could have easily been in the same movie and would have made it a million times better. Learn how to emote, Ben. It's not that hard, and people do it all the time. In this movie, he's the same old Ben with no facial expressions, no purpose behind his dialogue, he's just going through the motions like a poorly designed android. Needless to say, it was very hard for me to watch this movie, and I had to pause it multiple times because of all the yelling that I was doing every time that he was on the screen. In this movie, Rosamund Pike plays a woman who mysteriously disappears, and at the same time that this occurs, a crop circle mysteriously appears in the town that she was in. Her husband, played by none other than good old Ben, gets blamed for her disappearance, since the spouse is always the prime suspect, and because they also find blood on his kitchen knife, as well as a trail of the blood that leads into the woods. And so he gets arrested after police find this blood. Now, in this movie, Ben plays an astronomer who has been studying aliens and alien-related occurrences for most of his life, which infuriates me, since Ben isn't able to portray a normal character, let alone play a character with a brain. In all honesty, there really aren't any characters that Ben can play well. And yet, he's a famous actor with buttloads of cash and has friends in high places. Anyways, the police release him since they do not have enough concrete evidence, but he will need to go to trial within a week since everyone thinks that he killed her. And if the jury decides that he was guilty, regardless of what the police can gather as evidence, then he will go to prison for life. And so it's up to him to find out exactly what happened to her. He realizes that the crop circle and her disappearance are linked somehow, and manages to find the source of the crop circle. And after investigating and trespassing into secret government facilities without being detected, he finds out that this whole ordeal was part of some big government conspiracy, since she was an alien all along, and left so that she can go to her homeland once she found out all of the secrets of our world and how to basically end all of human life in order for her species to come to Earth. Unfortunately for her, the government was able to capture her while she was still in Earth's orbit and imprison her in Area 52. Of course, no one could ever find out about this, which is why they made it look like Ben killed her and hid her body somewhere to keep people from the truth. Ben realizes that if he exposes what he found out, that people all over the world would begin to panic and cause so much chaos that probably a lot of people would end up dead, if they would even believe him at all. And so, he decides to sacrifice himself for the greater good. He goes to trial and he even pleads guilty, admitting that he killed her, and so he gets thrown into prison where he is beaten and sodomized daily. One of the secret agents from Area 52, played by Neil Patrick Harris, visits him, pretending to be his work colleague. And of course, Ben recognizes him because he saw Neil while he was at Area 52. Ben tells Neil that he knows the truth about his wife who is being held captive at Area 52, and that he hasn't told anyone, nor will he tell anyone, so they should release him, mainly because his rectum just can't take it anymore. Neil reports back to his superiors, and they decide to release Ben after a few years by giving the police new evidence, which exonerates him, regardless of the fact that he pleaded guilty. Ben tries to forget about Rosamond and his past and the time that he spent in prison, but he's unable to, until he meets another woman, played by Kim Dickens, who helps him move forward with his life, and they end up getting married. Eventually, Ben finds out that Kim is also an alien, but from a different planet than Rosamond, and that she also wants to destroy planet Earth. After everything that Ben went through, being wrongfully imprisoned for the greater good, and having his anal cavity being filled on a consistent basis, rather than go to the government and tell them about her, and risk being imprisoned again for her disappearance, he decides to help her carry out her plan instead, and help her end the entire human species. I rate this movie a solid 4 out of 10. I just can't watch a Ben Affleck movie without feeling rage throughout my entire body. Now, aside from him, the rest of the movie was okay, I guess. The story was original and not predictable at all. I mean, I would have never guessed that there would be aliens in this film, but there were. The other actors were all fine, and they did a decent job portraying their characters. The directing was, you know, as good as it could be when you have a mannequin as the main actor. I like Dave, and I like how he makes movies. But when he attached himself to this movie, knowing that Ben will be in it and will star in it, well, that's when he lost some of my respect. I still think that he's a good director, but hopefully he'll be a little bit more picky when he chooses the movies that he will work on from this point forward, because some movies will bring your reputation down, this one being a prime example. So if you guys haven't seen this movie, don't bother, really. Drinking an entire bottle of hot sauce while walking on broken glass and then jumping into a huge tub of human excrement is a much more enjoyable experience than watching Ben play, well, himself. And for those of you who've already seen this movie, I'm so sorry for you. I truly am. I know your pain, and you just have to push through it, because you shouldn't let a movie or actor bring you down, no matter how horrible they are. The best thing to do is to learn from this experience and just make sure you never watch another Ben Affleck movie ever again. Even if he pays you to watch his movies, just don't do it. If no one watches his movies anymore, then maybe, just maybe, the execs in Hollywood will stop casting him and we'll never have to see his stupid face ever again. One can only hope. If we all work together, there's nothing that we can't accomplish. Always remember that. I'll see you guys next week.